Good morning. Today something different. Today we're gonna do some workshop type video. In theory, this is all I need: 2 10mm wrenches and some thinner, a bucket with highly purified water. It's clean. I'm gonna take off the shift lever, because if you saw the last Miele video, that one was going loose again. I'll explain more later. I might try to use one of these two to make it permanently stick. Obviously, if it goes wrong, then I'm double fucked. First, we have to take the lever off. Now I really need to get one of these in size 10. That would make my life so much easier, that one that spins. One day. Before you ask me, do you touch your camera with your dirty hands? No. At this moment I'm using Motul hands clean without water, which really works great. Got everything soaking in the thinner. I got a old bottle of thinner that I will re-put this one in for the very dirty work. I got a new bottle of thinner for the very clean work. Also quickly I'm going to clean the instruments, so I got clean hands where I reinstall everything, so I don't mess that stuff up. Everything is clean. The bolts and nuts are clean. Clean the bike first, then clean this part. That is dry. Clean the bike again. So now we're gonna put them back. You can see those teeth inside. They're also on the shaft. Especially on the shaft, they're quite worn down. I've already seen one or two on this one, which is new, that also are worn down. So that's the main problem. I'm going to go back to the bike. I'm really thinking about using that one. So let's see this stuff. So it's 2 compounds. You have to knee it together and then install it. You see how much room it has. This was tight together when it was on the bike. Okay, let's put it in together. Quick update, that's the bolt. You can see it has a problem. And of course that happened while it was on the bike, so I had to clean all the metal stuff out of it again. I have 3 solutions I had to run upstairs for. But that one is a crosshead, that one is a flathead. This one is a size 10, but it's too long. So I'm gonna try to make it the proper size. If that fails, then I have to use one of those 2. Why do things have to go wrong always? So the bolt is sawn off, and I have to do this with one hand. little bit longer. Just a little bit. Not much. When you saw to a bolt to shorten it, quick pro tip, it's smart to put a nut on the end you want to keep. Just quickly use some sanding paper to make the edges clean and then unnut it. That way it is also very very easy to get the nut back on instead of sawing it and then try to get the nut back on it. So this works perfectly. I also use the sanding paper to make this hole a little bit bigger again so I can squeeze it tighter. And considering the fact that it is past 2 in the afternoon and I haven't had anything to eat or drink since 11 o'clock, I got myself a new Monster Punch, the purple one. Damn, I love that one. These two products both are lifesavers. But sadly enough, I'm not sponsored. Okay, now we need to get everything back on for the second time. I really want a ratchet wrench. That would make my life so much easier. Also decided not to use the paste because it's a pain in the ass to remove, so we're going to try this one. Let's see how that goes. So that's the pesky bolt. Instructions say it needs to dry 4 hours and then needs to stay on its place, non-moving, for at least 24 hours. So no motorcycle riding today, no motorcycle riding tomorrow for a big part of the day. Maybe tomorrow, we shall see. Thanks for watching, and if you'd like to see more of this type of videos, please say so, hopefully in better conditions than this. Hey, thanks for watching, give it a like, and I'll see you guys soon.